This is my favorite handheld, the R36S. And what still amazes me the most is the community around this console. They just never stop pushing the limits of what this little device can do. Not long ago, I showed you how to install Android on it and even run GTA San Andreas. But today, I'll show you something even crazier, how you can install two or more operating systems on the same console and switch between them when turning it on or rebooting. Yeah, you heard that right. In this video, I'll show you a step-by-step guide on installing a multi-boot firmware with two systems on board, LineageOS and ArcOS. I'm incredibly thankful to all of the developers who made this possible. This is exactly what the R36S was missing – the ability to switch between firmwares. Alright, let's get started. As always, I strongly recommend checking if your console is genuine before flashing anything. You can do this on a special page. The link is in the description box, since lately there has been a rise in clones being sold as originals. Next, I also suggest replacing the stock SD cards with branded ones. The default ones included with the console are usually very low quality and can fail anytime. You'll find a link to a list of compatible SD cards in the description box. To install multi-boot firmware, besides the R36S itself, we'll need a microSD card. I'm using a 64 GB codec. By the way, you can grab the R36S and a new SD card on AliExpress. And to make your purchase even more affordable, I recommend using my promo codes. You'll find all the links and extra details down in the description box. First, we need to find out which screen version your console has. To do that, I remove the default SD card and insert it into my computer. Then I go to a special website that helps identify the screen type. You'll find the link in the description box. Read the instructions carefully. We need to upload a file with one of these names. On the SD card in the boot section, I select the needed file. Then I click Identify my screen. As you can see, mine has the original screen. In your case, it might show Panel 4 or something else. Important note, if you see this message, it most likely means you uploaded the wrong file or your console has a Panel 4 screen. Sometimes newer consoles with Panel 4 can show this message. Just continue with the installation for the Panel 4 screen. However, if you don't see these files in the boot section or there is no boot partition on your SD card at all, there is a high chance your console is a clone. I recommend checking your device against the main differences between the original and the clone. Alright, I've identified my screen version. Now I need to download the firmware files. To do that, I head over to GitHub. The link is in the description box. In my case, the latest firmware is from August 15th. Just below, there is a page that generates download files. I choose two firmwares, ArcOS and Android. If you want more systems installed at once, just check their boxes too. Two download links appear. I grab both archives. After downloading, I extract them using a free Mac app called the Unarchiver. It automatically combines all parts into one big archive, which I can then unpack with a double click using the built-in extractor. If you're on Windows, use 7-zip instead. Now I've got a firmware file in IMG format. Before flashing it, I'll format my new SD card in Disk Utility to exFAT. I've already shown you several times how to flash firmware onto an SD card. I use a free app called Balina Etcher. It's super easy and works on both Mac and Windows. Once the flashing process is done, I eject the SD card. On the first boot, you'll need to select your screen version following the instructions on GitHub. By default, the firmware is set to Panel 4, so if that's your version, you probably don't need to do anything. Installation should start automatically. In my case, I need to hold down R1 and A when turning it on to select the original panel. As you can see, the console powered on, showed a white screen, and turned off. Now I power it on again. And this time I see the R36S boot logo. After that, the ArcOS installation starts automatically. This process takes a while, so be patient. When it's done, the console reboots and launches ArcOS. It's ready to use. And before we continue, please like and subscribe to the channel and leave a comment. This helps me promote the channel. Also, you can click the bell icon so you don't miss any new videos. Thank you for your attention. Let's continue. First thing I do is open the Options menu and select device type. In my case, that's R35S or R36S. By the way, I recently made a video explaining all the basic options and settings for the R36S. I'm sure you'll find it really helpful. The link is in the description box. Alright, my controller settings have been applied, and now we can move on to installing the second firmware, LineageOS. To do that, I open the main menu and restart the console. When it powers back on, according to the GitHub guide, I need to hold down Function and A. As you can see, nothing happens. Black screen. That's because the boot files for the original screen are missing. I talked about the same issue in my LineageOS installation video. The bug has already been fixed in the newer firmware, but since this build uses an older LineageOS version, we'll need to add the correct boot files manually. You can download them from my Telegram channel, links in the description. Just copy them into the panels folder inside the Endwood directory and then into the root folder, replacing the existing files. Once that's done, eject the SD card. Now insert it back into the first slot. Turn the console on again, holding Function and A. The second firmware installation begins. All we have to do now is wait. When it's done, go through the initial setup. I covered this in detail in a separate video. And here we go. LineageOS has booted up and we're on the home screen. I'd call that a win. Let me show you again how the system switching works. I restart the console and hold Function and Start, and it boots into ArcOS. Everything runs smoothly. Now I reboot the R36S once more and hold Function and A, it boots into LineageOS. Android starts up, the launcher loads, and we're in. No games here yet, but that's easy to fix. Just insert a second SD card with your game collection. That's a topic for another video though. So now you can easily switch between firmwares and have not just one, but several operating systems on your R36S, which means access to a much wider library of games and the best features from each system. I hope you enjoyed this video. Please like and subscribe to the channel. I wish you pleasant nostalgia and successful completion of your favorite games.